Thank you, Paul, for introducing. So, and thank you for your introduction to the topic, because indeed the data for substandard and falsified medicines and products are very fragmented, and there is poor transparency, which makes it impossible to assess the health impact of the poor quality medicines and to make accurate evidence-based decisions on effective countermeasures. And therefore, with the Medicines Quality Research Group, we really want to facilitate access to evidence. And the group created data sharing platforms and tools to put information together on the quality of medicines. And in doing so, providing ready and easy access to information. So for some scientific data, Paul showed you the surveyor that we are using. But there is so many information that is not captured in the scientific literature. And therefore, the group developed a platform, the GLOBE, that actually brings together information from the lay press on medicine quality, on poor quality medicines. So, and to give you a flavor of how this looks like, so we're mapping publicly available information on the quality of medicines, and the information comes mainly from Google News. We're following Google News in 5 different languages. And for example, if I'm interested in Valsartan, I would type that into the search box, and it would give me all the locations where there are reports or lay press articles on this. When I click on the pin, or when the user clicks on the pin, there is the link to the source article, and curated information is available. It will give a brief overview, like which product is involved, what was the quality of the medicine that was found, and what was the source where the product was found. So users can filter by date, they can filter by country, by a search term that they prefer. And if they would want to, they can download a customized report, for example, in this case for Valsartan incidents that happened. So how are we actually populating or giving input to this GLOBE? We are using a system that scrapes newspapers online, mainly referenced in Google News. And articles that are matching the search terms will appear in our database. And will be loaded into our database, apologies. And trained analysts will subsequently filter and curate these articles. So only the relevant articles will appear in the Medicines Quality Monitoring GLOBE. And each pin on this GLOBE reports is actually an article that reports on incidents of substandard, falsified, unregistered, and diverted products. And the principal target users are medicines regulatory authorities, international organizations, and for example, professionals working in a country that are interested in this topic. And since the beginning of our system in 2018, we have more than 5,800 articles that actually report on incidents of substandard and falsified medicines. Of course, these are journalistic reports and therefore maybe intrinsically less reliable than scientific papers, but we really see it as an early warning system for potential problems, and we want to point out that there might be further investigation needed there. But in the context, for example, of COVID-19, it's relevant to have these early warning systems, and I want to give you an example of what the GLOBE can actually tell us. So for COVID-19, we adapted the GLOBE. We added specific search terms to be sure to capture these type of products within Google News, and also users on the GLOBE can actually download reports that are grouping certain product categories. So with COVID, we see that there is a high demand for products, and there is shortage of genuine products, and that this actually leads to an increase in articles that are related to this. So a kind of parallel pandemic of substandard and falsified medicines. And since the beginning of the pandemic, up to now, July 2021, we identified almost 850 relevant articles on quality problems with COVID-19 products in over 60 countries. So it's not only problems with medicines that we see, there is many problems involved in our GLOBE. We see there is problems with hand sanitizers, with personal protective equipment, with ventilation equipment, with vaccines. And the timing in which these products or articles on these incidents appear, it comes somehow in waves. For example, at the beginning of the pandemic, there was a wave of quality issues with PPE. And here on the slide, you see the example for diagnostics that were when there was a higher demand in the beginning of the pandemic. And then further on in the pandemic, as soon, for example, at the end of December 2020, when the big vaccination campaigns actually started for COVID-19 vaccines, we saw an increase in alerts in the globe. So it's really a wide range of products that is affected by this issue of substandard and falsified incidents. And each of them have a different regulation, and each of them need different quality assurance and quality control measures in order to prevent them. So what the globe does not tell us is that the data are geographically heterogeneous. And an important caveat with this is that it's not because there is no reports from a country that the medicines product quality there is necessarily good. It may be just implied that there is no or few access to available data. And similarly, it's not because there is a lot of poor reports on poor quality products that in this country, the quality of the product is generally worse than in another country where there are less reports. And one of the reasons, obviously, is we're only following articles in 5 languages. We are planning to extend this and follow follow up in more languages. But there is also other phenomena that are at play here and that actually need further research, such as, for example, reporting fatigue. We saw in the beginning of the pandemic that there was an increase in masks, and then it went down later on. But apparently in the beginning of 2021, there was a new increase in SF masks, and that's for the US Customs and Border Control saw that in their figures, but we did not see this reflected in the data from our globe. There is also reluctance from international organizations, for example, for COVID-19, to talk about the problem of substandard and falsified medicines, because it might nurture or feed the vaccine hesitancy. Also, companies might be afraid for reputational harm, so they don't really disclose the information. Furthermore, in lay press articles, very often there is a confusion between the different type of terms that are used. Falsified and substandard are not always well defined necessarily, so we need to be careful when we want to interpret this information, because the drivers for substandard are very different than the ones for falsified, for example. And therefore, yeah, the information of the globe, we have to realize throughout whatever we are doing with this data that there is no scientific confirmation. And therefore, the information needs to be, like I said, interpreted with greatest precaution. But the information has additional valuable information on quality of certain medicines and on certain incidents that are happening in the world. And we really want to see it as an early warning system. And therefore, we really have the feeling that there is a need to have the discussion on how we can grade the quality of evidence on substandard and falsified medicine, so we can take into account all the resources of information that are available. There is a need for this data grading, data quality grading system. So with what the globe does tell us, we can increase awareness of the problems amongst key stakeholders that are working in this domain. And the data that we have, we can use it to find the drivers for different products and different geographical areas. We are also planning to do a temporal analysis. So for example, between when the needs arise for a certain product or when a certain product was claimed to be useful, for example, hydroxychloroquine, and how much time does it take before there is actually a substandard and falsified incidents happening, or when are these products appearing in the market. But also actually the information that the globe does not tell us. So with this lay press information, we already try to fill some part of the gap, but it also further gives us an understanding of what gaps are still left in the data, and it reveals us areas for research on medicine quality. So we can target the intervention of medicine quality problems, and we can collect evidence to fill the knowledge gaps. And the information that we don't have actually also encourages us to think about better system for sharing data in an objective and timely manner, and to the people that actually should know, so they can take appropriate countermeasures and so these can be implemented. Thank you very much.